tell us what you want us to do.
Read them out, if you would.
In any order?
Yeah. So, so Donald, you do your one first, and then I'll come. Yeah, let's do that. So, and off you go.
I also remember messing around on my bike during my paper round, and a policeman telling my father. Once, when the grass in Queen's Park was left unmown, some boys from the village set fire to the grass with some matches, and I hid behind the rock when the police arrived. I also did that on the grass verge on the way home from swimming in Uxbridge. Found a box of squash matches and set fire to the grass verge, got on my bike and did a runner.
In Uxbridge, huh?
Well, that's when it was all fields.
Yeah.
Mum used to make...
Wait for action. And action.
Mum used to make all my clothes, or else they would be handed down to me from a sister or a cousin. We all had a dress for Sunday best. We weren't allowed to wear it any other day.
Lovely. Who's next?
Go on, you've got hundreds up there. Do some more.
Wait a minute. Bell.
I still have the same...
Okay, action.
I still have the same colour hair I always did. That's because I didn't get it dyed. My daughter dyed her hair, and now she's grey. My mum had a black dress. My dad used to shave and get hairs all over her dress. All I remember is Charlie Chaplin and John Wayne films, Saturday morning cinema for the children, and a tangerine velvet dress.
You could use conkers to do the same job as mothballs or chestnuts. Cheaper they were.
Every day was a routine. Monday was wash day with a copper in the corner. Tuesday was ironing. Wednesday the bedrooms got done. Thursday was downstairs. Friday was bath night. Women did it all. And we helped in the garden if we had one.
Once they let me drive the tram. I asked every day till I drove them and they said yes. But the school got to hear about it and gave me what for. I was 9.
Could you do that again? Because till I drove them mad, wasn't it? No?
No, it should be. I think it ought to be altered.
Yeah.
Yeah. Brilliant. Once they let me drive a tram. I asked them every day till I drove them mad, and then they said yes. But the school got to hear about it and gave me what for. I was 9 at the time.
Yeah, all of them?
Oh no, anyway, I haven't got this one.
I've got another one on here. Excuse me.
Okay, hang on, let's wait for Okay,
everyone used lavender. We grew lavender in the garden. It was my job each day to bring some into the house.
When the wireless was on, we weren't allowed to talk.
Again, I've got a sneeze. I've got a sneeze in the background. Do that again.
When the wireless was on, we weren't allowed to talk. Have you?
Can you do the routine one again? Bless you. Every day was a routine, that one, because we had singing in the background.
Every day was a routine. Monday was wash day with the copper in the kitchen. Tuesday was ironing. Wednesday the bedrooms got done. Thursday was downstairs. Friday was bath night. Women did it all, and we helped in the garden if we had one.
Hang on, we've got to stand in
the doors. There's a load
of... Okay, we're rolling. Where you go?
Every day was routine. Monday was wash day with the copper in the kitchen. Tuesday was ironing. Wednesday the bedrooms got done. Thursday was downstairs. Friday was bath night. Women did it all. And we helped in the garden if we had one.
Lovely.
Yeah, when I was a lad, I used to have a new pair of trousers, short trousers, not long trousers, every month. And that new pair was for Sunday best for a month. A month for going to school in, and a month for playing in.
Brilliant.
I remember having a green silk dress.
Start again.
I remember having a green silk dress. Well, it seemed like silk to me when I was 12. And I got on the bus to go into Uxbridge with my mum and sat on the little bucket seat at the front near the driver. And the electric light bulb from above the seat had fallen out onto the seat, and I sat on it. And it cut me right through my green silk dress. And everybody told my mum she should have got onto the bus company to pay for a new one. But she didn't.
That's fantastic. That's brilliant.
Oh, crumbs. I remember going to a dance at Moor Park Mansion when my dad worked at Moor Park. And I had a blue satin dress. I don't know where it came from. It was handed down to me. And my mum made me wear my school stockings and shoes, and they were black. So when we got to the dance, I went to the cloakroom and took them off. And mum couldn't tell me off in front of all the people there, so I got away with it.
Very good.
Dad's mother was a cleaner in the House of Commons, and he had no father, but somehow or other she'd managed to afford to buy him a bike. And I still have the press cuttings where he got fined 5 shillings for riding on the pavement in the dark with no lights on his bike. Oh. And 5 shillings in those days was the best part of, I don't know, about a sixth of your weekly wage.
So what did, when you played, you guys, and you played in the playground at Harefield, what games did you play?
Oh, we played Orny Orny, I'm a coming.
We played hopscotch and ball games. And some game where somebody bent over against the wall and you had to run up to them and do a leapfrog onto their back.
That was Orny Orny, I'm a coming.
Oh, was it? Yeah. Oh, I didn't know that's what it was called.
You shouted out, Orny Orny, I'm a coming, and you ran and you leapt on. And then the next one ran and leapt on, and the idea was how many you could get on the before it all fell over.
Yeah, I remember that.
And that's the basis of the rules of rugby.
To a certain extent it is, isn't it? And we played marbles, of course. And in the summer, you used to sit on the playground up against the corrugated iron of the woodwork shop and with our magnifying glasses and try and melt the tar on the playground or set fire to somebody's trousers or something equally wicked.
Can't think of anything else. Is that one called Horny Horny I'm A-Coming?
Haven't got a clue. And it's slightly rude now.
That's very rude,
and,
yes.
What about, you used to tell me that you sharpen your pencils in the bricks.
Oh, yes.
No, not pencils, slate.
Slate pencils, slate were. Pencils. They were. Yeah, they were ordinary lead pencils. They were.
It was like a stick of slate, wasn't it? Round, round slate.
And you wrote on your...
Slate.
On your slate, yes.
Yeah. Which was a slate with a wooden border.
That's right, yes. And you could sharpen them in the bricks. And a lot of the bricks in the old school had grooves all in them where generations of kids had sharpened their slate pencils.
In the Memorial Hall where we lived, Barb and I lived when we first got married. All round that end where the cottage was slots in the wall where they'd sharpened their slate pencils.
Yeah, because I can remember seeing those because I went to the same school when I was... kid and saw those there and the that ridge about halfway up the wall there was a kind of little lip I don't know what you call it, but you could drive your toy cars all the way around the school on those.
And the steps to the infants were like that as well, weren't they? We had slates and slate pencils in the infants when I started school. And we used to use cowrie shells as counters.
Wow.
And little tiny cowrie shells. Nowadays they have sticks, don't they? Different colours.
Yeah, made of plastic. They were wooden when I was at school.
Oh, were, yeah.
Units and tens and hundreds. Yeah.
Now they're plastic.
Yeah, different colours.
Well, I know, remember when I started school at 5, I was in a class of 52 kids.
Yeah,
And they sat, we didn't have desks, they sat in rows, in a tiered sort of benches. They were and the teacher taught the whole class, 52 kids. We spent a lot of time learning things by rote and chanting. And that's how I know all my tables, because that's how we used to learn how tables. And spellings and poems. And I was in Miss Mott's class.
We were all in Miss Mott's class.
And she must have gone straight from college to Harefield School, and she stayed there till she retired. But she, I thought she was old. I mean, she could only have been about 20.
Mm.
And she had a song for everything, didn't she?
Yeah.
It doesn't matter what occurred, Miss Mott had a little song that we all sang, you know. So we knew all the nursery rhymes and all the songs and all the tables and all the spellings just off by heart.
And if it got dark and there was a suggestion of a thunderstorm, she would say, "Now listen, children, I'm going to light the gas. You listen to what the gas says." And she would go, "G is for gas." Because that's the sound it made as the flame caught the gas.
Mm-hmm. She must have been a brilliant teacher.
Cool.
Yeah.